What heart could hold the weight? What heart could hold the weight of?
You may be sitting next to somebody tonight that really don't know what's going on. You may be sitting next to somebody tonight that don't have an emergency. But tonight you sitting in the victory seat. Tonight you better go ahead and break out in praise. Tonight if you watching my internet, the Holy Ghost told me to tell you that the seat that you sitting in tonight, it ain't your kitchen seat. It ain't your house seat. It's not your office seat. It's a seat of victory. Somebody give them a praise right now.
Y'all sit down for a second.
It's a seat of victory. A seat of victory. A seat of victory. A seat of victory. Right where you sit, you got the victory. Right where you sit, the devil is defeated. Oh, you better praise him like you believe it. See, this is the atmosphere that you praise him over into the victory. You praise him until your mind knows you got the victory. You praise him until your spirit say you got the victory. Somebody give him praise right now, right now. Today. Today is a day of shifting. Today is a day of movement. Today is a day of repositioning. Today is a day where he picks you up from your old spot and sets your spirit over in a new spot. And all he needs you to do tonight is receive a new mindset. Who am I talking to right now? God, all I need is for one person to believe that God is resetting you. I'm not hearing nobody talk about he's shifting you. I'm not hearing nobody shout right now. I said he's repositioning you. That's why you gotta praise him. That's why your warfare was heavy. That's why the devil didn't want you to make it here. Because tonight he shifts you to another place.
When I saw him coming, the ghetto in me picked up a brick. I said, come on. Come on down here. So I had the brick behind me like this. And I got in my ghetto posture. So the closer he got, he started looking. And he saw the brick. By the time he got about from where there to that pole is, he said, Juanita, I said, Wesley, I will knock your head. When he saw the brick, he said, put that brick down, girl. I'm gonna call your daddy. I'm gonna call your daddy right now. You better put that brick down. You better not hit me with no brick. Backing up in the cell phone, talking about, put the brick down, Juanita. Juanita, put the brick down. Why you gonna hit me with a brick? Put the brick down.
Could hold the weight.
church hopping. I get scared of people who just want it after a word all the time. I get scared of that because if my womb is precious, I'm not going to let it get contaminated by just anybody. The Bible says in Galatians chapter 3, verse 1, you foolish Galatians, who has bewitched you that you should not obey the truth?
Here at New Destiny Christian Center named Paula White as the new senior pastor, succeeding the late pastor Zachary Timms. But today, Timms' ex-wife says she is the rightful successor.
And I'm here to declare to you today that as founder of New Destiny Christian Center, that I am the real mother.
Yeah. Pastor Reva Timms and her late ex-husband started New Destiny Christian Church in 1996 with four members. It grew into thousands. Pastor Zachary Timms was found dead in a New York hotel in August. Seeking his replacement has been a long process, one Timms says, which did not include her.
The board has refused to meet with me. They have refused to meet with me in any fashion of any kind, and so has Pastor Paula White.
Here's the part that,
Paula White is founder of Without Walls International Church, but she's controversial. She's known as a prosperity preacher, sending a message that encourages followers to give money in return for blessings. Timms' attorney has filed a lawsuit against the board of New Destiny and Paula White.
There are several counts concerning the board, concerning Paula White, and the activity that the board has taken, which we feel is illegal.
But I would have you know that the head of every man is Christ, and the head of the woman is the man, and the head of Christ is God. But I suffer not a woman to teach, nor to usurp authority over the man, but to be in silence. For Adam was first formed, then Eve. And Adam was not deceived, but the woman being deceived was in the transgression.
For the Lord Jesus Christ, his glory is in this house. There's an anointing to destroy every yoke, to remove every burden. Somebody crossed the threshold of their destiny when they stepped into the holy sacredness of this sanctuary, and God has opened something up that heaven is about to kiss you, favor is about to fall on you, God is about to promote you. There's something being released in your life that has been pent up, dormant on the inside. There is a breaking that God is going to bring that's going to manifest, that your families are going to say, you look different after this Sunday. You talk different after this Sunday. There's a manifestation that's going to bring an evidence of change, because everything is about to change position in your life. God has set you in a sovereign season. Your weeping is over. Your joy has come. It's morning time for you. It's been a setup, and you're getting ready to go to a greater place than you've ever been before.
I would have you know that the head of every man is Christ, and the head of the woman is the man, and the head of Christ is God. But I suffer not a woman to teach, nor to usurp authority over the man, but to be in silence. For Adam was first formed, then Eve. And Adam was not deceived, but the woman being deceived was in the transgression.